All right, now you can see the questions on the screen. Okay, first three questions. Anybody any doubt? In third question, how it is a parabola? Anybody want to tell in third question how it is a parabola? Why nobody is answering?
So we can find the equation and we can prove x square equal to a.
Yes, correct. You have to eliminate t and get the relation between x and y. In that, we'll get x square equal to a b. That's why it's better. Good. Okay, 4, 5, 6. Anybody any doubt?
Sixth one, sir.
Sixth one, okay. Y equal to ax square plus bx plus c. They wanted some details. They wanted focus. Okay. You can take a common, make perfect square, x square plus b by a into x plus c by a. That is a into x square plus 2 into x into b by 2a plus c by a minus b by 2a whole square. Whatever I required for perfect square, I want to add and subtract. So plus b by 2a whole square minus b by 2a whole square plus c by a. That is x plus b by 2a whole square plus 4ac minus b square by 4a square. You can open this and bring this one here. We'll get y minus 4ac minus b square by 4a is equal to a into x plus b by 2a whole square. Even this a, I should bring it down as 1 by a after bringing this side. Okay. That is x minus minus b by 2a whole square is equal to 1 by a into y minus 4ac minus b square by 4a. Now it is in the standard form. X minus x whole square equal to 4a into y minus k. Normally focus is 0 comma a, but now because of translation it is h comma k plus a. If we take x minus h whole square equal to, I'll write capital A here, into y minus k, focus is normally 0 comma a. Now I have to add h and add k. Okay, that h is this, so minus b by 2, and that a is the 1 by 4a, because 4a is this, so it will be 1 by 4a plus k is this 4ac minus b square by 4a. Okay, so I think x coordinate is there and y coordinate, take LCM, 1 plus 4ac minus b square by option B. Is it okay for sixth question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Of course, parabola we do like this, but I can also do slightly different. Actually, this is a vertical parabola like this. I want to find lowest point, the vertex. At the vertex, derivative is 0, right? Okay. If you find a dy by dx and equate it to 0, we will get x as minus b by 2. Substitute minus b by 2a there, you will get 4ac minus b square by 4a. Okay. That is local minimum value. You will also study about this in quadratic equations chapter later on. Okay. Because this is a quadratic expression, What is the minimum value of that? Formula is 4ac minus b square by 4a. So you'll be remembering this later on after quadratic equation. Once that is known, you have to just move vertex upward by how much? A units. Okay, that a units here is 1 by 4a. I also told in the class notes. I think for this length of lattice rectum is 1 by a. You remember that? I said if you want length of lattice rectum, don't have to do all this. You take a common and bring it here, you will see some perfect square equal to 1 by a into something. What is this? What is this? Not so important. If you want length of lattice rectum, directly 1 by a is length of lattice rectum. In the notes, I gave this statement. For this length of lattice rectum is 1 by a. If length of lattice rectum is 1 by a, that is 4a, 1/4 of that is 1 by 4a. For this y coordinate, add 1 by 4a, you will get this point. That is exactly the answer. Okay. So without all this, you can do if you remember the vertex or get by calculus. Okay, 7 or 8, anybody need out?
8, 8, 1.
The length of lattice. When focus and directrix are given, how will you find length of lattice rectum? Even if you rotate a parabola, some relative thing doesn't change. What is that? This is A, this is A, this is 2A, this is 2A. If you know focus and if you know directrix, okay, if I take a parabola, this is a focus, this is a vertex, this is a directrix, these are ends of lattice rectum. Even if you rotate it, whenever this is K, this will be K, this will be 2K, this will be 2K. So if you know focus and directrix, find perpendicular distance between them. The double of that will be length of lattice rectum. Okay. So now in this question, what they give? They gave y equal to, means it's a horizontal line, not a big issue. Okay, so we have like this and like this, and this is y is equal to u square by 2c. And this focus is u square by 2g sine 2 alpha minus u square by 2g cos 2 alpha. Okay, so this is a parabola, maybe downward, doesn't matter. This is a directrix, this is a focus. Simply find this distance. That will be this y coordinate minus this y coordinate directly. So you'll get u square by 2g plus or minus of minus u square by 2g cos 2 alpha same order. That is the distance between these two. And that is 2a. Okay. If I take u square by 2g common, 1 plus cos 2 alpha is 2 cos square alpha, 2, 2 will cancel. U square by g cos square alpha. If this is 2a, 4a will be 2 u square by g cos square alpha. Option D. Is it okay, 8th one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, up to 11. Anybody need doubt?
11th ones.
The vertex of the parabola, focus and directrix. Okay. Anybody want to give an idea? When vertex and directrix are given, how to find the focus and directrix are given, how to find vertex?
What we should find, sir?
Read the question. The screen. 11th question.
Sir, we can find.
Sir.
Yes.
If we find quota of that point on the directrix, sir, and we can take the midpoint. It is
yes, correct. Find foot of focus on directrix. And then midpoint of focus and that point will be the vertex. Okay, this may not be exact figure, but this is the focus, which is 2, 1. This is the directrix x minus 2y plus 10 equal to 0. Okay, so our process is known, told that is sufficient, but still find the foot of this on this directrix h minus 2y1. A minus 1 by minus 2 equal to minus 2 times 2 minus 2 plus 10 by 1 square plus 2 square. That is 2 minus 2 gone, 10 by 5 is 2 and minus 4 V. Then minus 4 plus 2. H comma K is equal to minus 2 and 9. Oh, I am finding image, I should find only foot. So this is minus 2 only. Then minus 2 plus 2 is 0. This is 4 plus 1, 5. Okay, this is 0 comma 5 apparently. Then midpoint of these two, 1 comma 3. Is it all right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so these are all quite conceptual in the sense that not that there is a formula. You understand physically what is the question and then you can devise a method for that. Up to 11, anybody, any other doubt? Up to 14?
The 15th.
15, you will just find the two ends of lattice rectum, join to origin, find the separate lines equations and multiply. I think the parabola doesn't even matter. I'm not going to even use that parabola equation.
So this question is there in IP also.
Okay. You take ends of lattice rectum a comma 2a and a comma minus 2a. This is L and this L dash, this origin, joined to this, joined to this. They want combined equation of these two. That a doesn't even matter actually, because what is this line equation is y equal to 2x. What is this line equation is y equal to minus 2x, because you know two points, you can find slope 2 and all. So 2x plus y equal to 0 is one line. 2x minus y equal to 0, another line, which is 4x square minus y square equal to 0. Y equal to 4x square. So that equation of parabola doesn't matter as long as it y square equal to 4x. All right, Sitaram?
Yes, sir.
Okay, up to 15, anything else? Okay, up to 18. No doubt. 19.
Yes, sir. 19th.
Yes, sir. 19th.
Okay. I think not exactly this, but some solid example is there in IP before the first exercise. I'm sure in civil engineering structures, parabola is involved in great detail. Okay, what is this question now? An arch is in the shape of a parabola whose axis is vertical downwards and measure 80 meters across its bottom on the ground. Okay, so like this. Okay, this is 80. And its highest point is 24. So, no, proper configuration. Like so. Okay, this is 40 and this is 24. The measure of the horizontal beam across its cross section at a height of 18. Okay. This height is 18. This L is how much? L by L. Okay. Okay. I'm sure I think some different things not exactly related to this. If you take two poles, two vertical poles, and from here to here, okay, let us say some rope is hanging like this, okay, freely on its due to its own weight. What is the shape of that? Okay, I remember these kind of questions we had in engineering. We have to find this equation, okay, based on the elasticity of this, some equation is there. Or let us say there is a wall and one beam, iron beam is, you know, part of it is inside the wall, other part is outside. It cannot lie completely horizontal, right?
Yes.
Okay. In the same way here, is it possible to get a string perfectly horizontal between the two points like this?
No, sir.
Why? No.
Sir, there is no force to balance vertical downward force.
Yes, correct. Vertically downward force weight is acting. Something should balance that, right? Okay. So there will be always some slack. It may be very light. If you increase the tension too much, the vertical component of tension can balance this. So if you want this angle to be very high, this tension also should be very high. I'm sure in physics you study something about that, right? Same thing here. Its own weight is pulling it down. So what is that trying to stop? So some anyway, it naturally bends. Okay. A little bit. There is some name. It's called cantilever beam. And what is the shape of that due to its own weight? All these things they study in civil engineering. And here and there, sometimes a parabola will come or some slight variation of parabola will come. Okay, at least you see some bridges like this, okay, with support from down like this, okay, sometimes, or sometimes the bridges are like this, you have two long pillars, there is a long rope, and lot of strings are attached and the bridge is hanging, right, okay. So, I don't remember all the details, what is the shape of this, some of them may be parabola, some of them may be semi-ellipses, like that, okay, and it is very important, especially for those who are making this. Not a small thing that you go and measure there. Everything is on the drawing. You know its equation and you should be able to know what is this gaps you are putting it, what is this height, and order all these steel wires from a steel plant or some manufacturing plant. And then you directly take there and weld it there. So all the lengths should be known well before. If it is short, then it will be a problem. Okay, right? So we are quite happy to see some bridges and stand there and take some photographs and put in statuses maybe, but a lot of hard work behind that. Okay, so much hard work in designing it and making it, and there's laborers who are constructing it, the steel plant people who work there. Okay, anyway, let us take, this is a parabola. I'm sure when you go by the road, some entrance, some colonies or some areas, archways will be there, entrance archways somewhat in this shape maybe. This is a parabola. This width is 80, so this is 40 and this is 40. And you want to construct this, maybe you thought it will not stand, so you want to keep a support beam here at a height of 18, what should be the length? Okay. I want to take this as the axis and this is y-axis. And I want to take this as 0, 0. Some downward parabola will be obviously in the form of x square equal to 4ay. It may be minus 4a, doesn't matter, a can be negative, all right? What are the coordinates of this point? This is 40, this is 24. So 40 comma minus 24. What are the coordinates of this point? This is L by 2. If this is 18, this will be 6. So this is L by 2 comma minus 6. Substitute 40 comma minus 24 here. You will get 40 whole square equal to 4a into minus 24. Substitute this point, you will get L by 2 whole square equal to 4a into minus 6. I can find 4a from here, substitute here, I will get L, or simply divide these two, 4a will be cancelled. So if I take this by this, or it's okay as it is like this, I will get 40 whole square by L by 2 whole square equal to 4a will cancel, I'll get 4. Now take L by 2 that side, you'll get 40 is equal to L by 2 into 2, if I remove the squares. So L is equal to 40. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, after understanding all this, understand this is 4a is negative, doesn't matter for me. I can find 4a and put it here or divide. Once you understand this, I don't have to write even this much. I can tell more quickly. From this equation, can I say y is proportional to x square?
Yes, sir.
Okay. From here to here, what happened to y coordinate?
Increase.
It became 1/4. Now from here to here, what happened to y coordinate? It became 1/4. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
If y coordinate becomes 1/4 because of the proportionality, what will happen to x coordinate?
Half.
Half. Here if x coordinate is 40, here x coordinate should be what?
20.
L by 2 is 20 means L is 40. That's it. Just based on proportionality. After all, that's what we have done. Proportionality. Y is proportional to x square. Okay. May not be exactly like this, but something like this is there. A solved example before first exercise in IP. May not be they might have given like this one bridge and lot of things like this. And they ask height of a particular string at so and so distance from the middle, something like this. Okay, anybody tried beyond 20 in parabola?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Up to 21, anybody any doubts? Which one? I could not hear which one you're asking.
So someone joined you not from our college, sir.
Okay, I'll check. Banu Prasad, who is this? Can you please respond? Otherwise, I have to remove you.
Sir, it's me, sir, Chandan.
Okay, why don't you rename yourself?
Yes.
Rajiv Kumar, you also have to rename. Don't write in Telugu and all these things. Put your proper roll number and write. Are you there? Pradeep.
Yes, sir.
Okay, rename properly.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. Up to 21. Any doubts, anybody? Up to 24.
Sir, 22, sir.
22. Okay. Okay, 22, basically the question is you take a parabola there are a lot of double ordinates. There are points of trisection dividing the ratio 1:2 and 2:1. Okay. When you join all of them, you'll get a new parabola. Okay. What are the locus of that? That's the question. Okay. Points of trisection is this, this, and this are equal. Okay. Two methods. I think an IP also is there, this question. Method one. I will take this point as x1 comma y1, the point on the locus. Okay. Anyone want to tell me what is this point will be? First of all, what is this point will be? If this is x1, y1, what is this point will be?
Fine.
X1 comma minus y1.
Okay. Now, what is the distance between these two? This is 2y1. So this should be 2y1. This should be 2y1. So what is this point will be?
X1 comma 2y1.
Sure.
X1 comma 3y1.
3y1. Already y1, you have to add 2y1. So it is x1 comma 3y1. This is x1 comma minus 3y1. This point and this point should satisfy the parabola equation. Substitute it to get it. That's it. y1 whole square equal to 4a into x1. 9y square equal to 4ax is the locus. Done. Method 2. Take this point as 80 square comma 280. This point is obviously 80 square comma minus 280. This point will be 80 square comma 280 by 3. And this point will be 80 square comma minus 280 by 3. So you have to find locus of this point. How I got this one? By section formula. 1:2 ratio, I got this. 2:1 ratio, I got this. How to find locus of these two points? 80 square comma plus or minus 280 by 3 is equal to x comma y. When I equate this and this, I'll get x is equal to 80 square. When I equate this and this, t will come. That is plus or minus 280 by 3 is y. From this, t will come 3y by 2a plus or minus. Put that t here, let x equal to a into plus or minus 3y by 2a whole square. That is 9y square by 4a square, we will get 9y square equal to 4ax. Is it all right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 23 or 24. Anybody any doubt? Okay. Anybody want to ask any doubts in advanced material circles? Yes. Anybody any doubts about advanced material?
Yes, sir, in more than one option.
Okay, let me share that. Okay, these are more than one answer. You want to tell specific number, I can show you that question, or you want to.
Sir, question it. Number 4.
Tangents are drawn from a point on the circle to another circle. The tangent tangent hit the circle at Q and R. Q R is also tangent to CQ. Okay. If you actually draw the figure that right, then that's very easy. Okay, we have two circles, concentric. Okay, now from a point on the bigger circle, you are drawing two tangents. Now this chord need not be tangent to this, but the circle is such a way that even that chord is also tangent. So, like this. Right? That's the question. Okay. Now, can I say PQ, QR, and RP? All three should have same length. Why? Because all these are chords of the big circle, and from the center, all of them are at same distance. So, all should have same length.
Same length.
And it's an equilateral triangle.
Yes.
Once it is equilateral triangle, and which radius is A, which radius is B? Tangents are drawn from, okay, so A is bigger radius, all right. So this is B and this is A. So we can say A is equal to 2B. Because it is not only in center, it is circumcenter, it is centroid, all this. No. Now if you want area of equal triangle, normally it is root 3 by 4. What is this? This is A. Okay, this is A. So, if in radius is B, you can try to find what is the side length. Or if this is A, this is A, this length will come A root 3 because this angle is 120, you can apply cosine root. Or A cos 30, you can use, you will get A root 3 by 2. Okay, the side length is coming A root 3. So, pi by 4 into A root 3 whole square. That is... what is this area of the triangle formula? You know, side, what is the formula for root 3 by 4 a square? Root 3 by 4 into a root 3 whole square, which is 3 root 3 by 4 a square. Okay, this is only in terms of a square. If you want in terms of b, in the place of a, substitute 2b. 3 root 3 by 4 into 2b whole square. Or in the place of 1a, only substitute that. We'll get 3 root 3 by 4 A into 2B. So this is one answer, this is one answer, this is one answer. Okay, that's all in terms of A, B, A and B. Any other doubts in circles, advanced material, anybody?
Sir, matching 4.
Okay, what is it? S1 is a circle touching the line at 1, minus 1, cutting orthogonally S2 and having the line segment as diameter. Okay. I think this is three column matching one or two times given in advanced exam, where you have to find all the details, each and everyone correct or not, and then only attempt the down part. Okay, there is a line 2x plus 3y, negative slope. Like this, one point is 1 comma minus 1. Okay, touching this line at this point, there are a lot of circles. This point is 1 comma minus 1 and the line is 2x plus 3y plus 1 equal to 0. And there is some other circle with 0 comma 3 minus 2 comma minus 1 as ends of diameter. You could intersect that orthogonally. This is 0, 3, minus 2, minus 2. Maybe I can only give an idea due to time. Okay. Any circle touching this line at this point will be in the form of S plus lambda L, where you can take S as point circle. X minus 1 whole square plus Y plus 1 whole square minus 0 square. Plus lambda into that line, 2X plus 3Y plus 1 equal to 0. Now, you know this circle. Okay, these two should enter. That circle is what? X minus 0 into x plus 2 plus y minus 3 into y plus 1 equal to 0. Apply orthogonality condition for this 2g g dash plus 2f. After expanding this properly, combine x times, y times, constant term. Apply orthogonality, you'll get lambda. Put that lambda back, you'll get the circle. I think once you know the circle, now we have to look at all the options. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
If I have time, some other time, I can write all the full solution, give it some idea. Okay, time is up. Full stop. Thank you.